Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Sue Donham's portrait of an artist in trouble. Death on canvas. Starring Peter Lupus. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation, The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. Also by State Farm Insurance, International Harvester, and Quaker State Motor Oil. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Have you ever looked carefully at a painting? Within the frame, beyond the image, beneath the paint itself, what you see is the artist, his soul bared before you, his secrets exposed. Today, a portrait in sound. We call it Death on Canvas. Picture this, a driving rain pelting the sidewalk along Gallery Row, West Hollywood, California. A lone man walking in the night.
I'm sorry, sir, but admission is by invitation only.
Look, I'm an old friend of John Duggan's. We used to share a studio. Now, he probably sent me an invitation, but I've moved. Well, he must be here. Ask him. My name's Zeno, Gary Zeno.
Admission is...
that the man? Howard of Venice Beach, Zeno?
Hey, Johnny, you really hit the big time, man. Cocktail party, art critics, the whole ball of wax.
It's been a long time coming, pal.
Well, it's been a long time since we set up easels on the boardwalk and drew portraits of the tourists.
Hey, you're still not doing that, are you?
No. Well, you know, I'm silk screening T-shirts and teaching on the side. Or is it the other way around?
I know what you mean.
Looks like your style's changed somewhat. Screaming nudes? Hey, is that Marianne in that painting?
Yes.
Well, how is she? And the baby? Linda?
We're divorced.
Oops, sorry.
No, that's cool. We had a falling out. Cheated, actually. I mean, a nervous breakdown.
Wow.
You know, I almost went off the deep end, too, after she did, but... Well, a shrink talked me out of it, you know?
Well, you both always were a little bit high-strung.
Dad, they're running low on champagne.
Linda, look. Under the dark glasses and the beard is an old friend, Gary Zeno. Where's Christine, honey? I want Cedar to meet her anyway.
She went outside for some air. It is awful smoky in here.
Hey, go get her, will you, honey? Huh?
Okay. Nice meeting you, Mr. Zeno.
Likewise. Who's Christine?
My wife. Hey, I've been married for 2 years. She's the other woman in the painting.
Very nice. Oh, I'd have used more purple highlights and spots, but I guess that's why I can't make a living painting.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you're going to love Christine Zeno. Marvelous girl. Excuse me for a minute. I got to go, circulate a little bit.
Pardon me, please. Coming through. Hey, I think I can get a glass of that before it's gone.
Help yourself.
Gracias.
Father!
Linda, what is it? What's wrong?
Where's my father?
I'm here, Linda. What's the matter? Where's Christine?
She's out in the car. She's dead.
Now, don't worry, Johnny. I'll see that Linda gets home.
She lives with her mother, you know.
Marianne? I thought...
Marianne's mother lives there, too. Mrs. Stone, you know?
I think I met her once. Hefty, kind of mean.
You met her all right. Hey, look, this question may take a while. Where can I reach you?
Well, I'm living in my car at the moment. Maybe it'd be better if you'd give me your number.
All right. Here's the number. Here's the address.
Thanks. Do you have any idea who might have done it?
Frankly, I've got a good idea.
Who?
My agent. Or ex-agent. Fritz Emanuel. I fired him last week, the crook.
What do you mean?
Well, he was making more money than I was. And Christine caught him at it. It was right there in the ledger, plain as day.
What's that you're writing, Linda?
Nothing much. Just a poem. Want to hear it?
Sure.
Grandma Stone says I have the makings of a real poet.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
It's called Visions of Marianne, number 4. Behold the shroud above me, descending darkly through night skies. Razor fingernails of doom rain down. I bow to their beck and call. Electric fields of heaven wail, and clouds bleed forever. That's all I have so far.
That's very good.
Thank you.
Visions of Marianne, number 4. Are the first three so gloomy?
All my poetry deals with death.
Marianne, your mother.
Yes. I'm like a translator in a way. I'm not sure she understands what I write.
Don't you ever ask her?
Oh, I guess you don't know my mother.
Well, I did, but that's been a long time ago.
Oh, that must have been before she got sick.
Must have been.
That was 5 years ago. She's been this way ever since.
This way?
When she got out of the hospital, my mother came to live with Grandma Stone and me. I was so happy to see her. She looked strange. She didn't cry or anything like that. Not out loud, anyway, but there was a tear, like, inside of her eye. She didn't say anything at all. She speaks little, even now. And she's never left the house. Mr. Zeno, to the rest of the world, my mother died 5 years ago. Thank you for bringing me home, Mr. Zeno. Would you like to come in?
Thanks, I would.
Linda, you're soaking wet. You should have taken... Who are you?
This is Mr. Zeno, Grandma. He brought me home.
Where's your father?
Well, he had some business, Mrs. Stone. I'll explain. May I come in?
Very well. Linda, get out of those wet clothes immediately.
Yes, Grandma.
Wipe your feet on the mat and hang up your wet coat on the rack. When you've done that, come into the parlor.
Yeah.
Explain your presence, Mr. Zeno. Haven't we met before?
Oh, actually, we have. I knew your daughter when we were in school.
Oh, you were the one who used to get drunk and throw beer bottles out of the window. I remember you.
Well, that was a long time ago. I haven't seen John or Marianne in years. I read about John's opening, so I showed up at the gallery tonight.
You must have met Christine then.
No, I didn't.
Grandma, did you hear what happened tonight?
Mr. Zeno can't seem to get to the point.
Somebody killed Christine. Strangled her.
Christine is dead?
Mother.
Hello, Marianne.
Oh, you shouldn't be up at this time of night, dear. Go back to your room. Zeno?
Oh, it's all right, Mother.
Now you've upset her. Take her to her room, Linda.
Yes, Grandma.
Mrs. Stone, I'm not here to upset things. I just wanted to tell you what happened and not to be frightened if the police come and ask questions. Your granddaughter found Christine. The police are talking to John now.
They don't know who did it.
No, not yet.
Well, I hope they find him soon. Not safe to walk the streets anymore.
Well, I'd better be going.
Mr. Zeno, wait. I want you to have my poems. They're carbon copies. I still have the original.
Thank you.
You'll come back, won't you?
Sure.
Good. I'll finish Visions of Marianne, number 4, and give you a copy.
And I'll look forward to that. Good night, Mrs. Stone. Good night, Linda.
Good night.
I've already talked to the police. I don't see what business this is of yours.
John Duggan's a friend of mine, Mr. Emanuel. You were his agent.
Well, what happened between John and me does not concern you.
Oh, sure it does. John owes me money. And from what I understand, you may have it.
You are a liar.
Well, you're a crook.
Look, I have a plane to catch.
Oh, busy, huh?
Oh, you are a cute one.
Oh, I'm a real doll. Now, look, agent, I was with John last night at the station. I call him at home this morning, and there's no answer. Somebody's wife is strangled to death. The guy doesn't just disappear overnight.
Well, maybe he's in mourning. Why don't you go back to your finger painting? Leave the detective stuff to the police.
Yeah, well, thanks for your time.
You don't mention.
Oh, I'm sorry I did.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Linda. Is your grandmother at home?
Oh, hi, Mr. Zeno. She went to the market.
You haven't heard from your father, have you?
No. Did you read about it in the papers?
Read about what?
The murder weapon. It's not a weapon, really. Christine was strangled with a nylon stocking. Isn't that weird?
Yeah. Linda, if your father calls, tell him I'd like to talk to him. Would you do that for me?
Sure. When are you coming by? I'll be done with the poem pretty soon. We can talk.
Well, I'll let you know. You be good now, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye.
Johnny! Oh, Zeno, I thought you were the cops. Come in, hurry.
What are you doing? Why haven't you answered your phone? I've been calling you all day.
Listen, I know what you're thinking. I mean, me packing and all this, but I didn't do it. Somebody's framing me, but good.
Well, what are you talking about?
Hey, you don't know about Fritz Emanuel?
Well, I saw him early this morning. My car broke down. I've been walking in the rain for the past 2 hours. What about Emanuel?
Oh, boy. Well, I don't know the details, but... Well, I've got to get rid of these letters. They'll burn me for sure. Fritz Emanuel's dead. Somebody strangled him.
I see Borman hasn't been here for quite a while. He lets me stay here when I need a place to work. Nice guy for an alcoholic.
Hey, look, Zeno, I can't ask you to do this for me.
Let me see those papers you want to get rid of. Trust me, Johnny. Duggan, while you're at home painting naked ladies, guess which model is posing for a certain agent? Is it really true that you're the last to know? It's unsigned.
They're all like that.
Well, who does this refer to? Your wife and Emanuel?
Well, apparently so.
Is it true?
No, I don't think it is. I mean, Christine denied it, and so did he. I confronted them both with it. But that's the real reason I fired Emanuel.
Now I see what you mean about those letters being incriminating. They give you a motive for both murders.
It's a pretty good frame.
Well, what about the stocking that was used to kill Christine?
Just a plain old nylon. Anyone can buy a pair practically anywhere. It wasn't Christine. She never wore them.
Johnny, burn those letters. Oh, wait a minute. Let me have one.
Where are you going?
To chip away some old paint.
Hi, Mr. Zeno. Guess what? I finished Visions of Marianne number 4. The police were here. They came after you called. They were looking for my father.
Well, what did you tell them?
I told them the truth. I don't know where he is.
Well, neither do I.
Who was that on the phone, Grandma?
Oh, a wrong number. Mr. Zeno, you're wet.
Well, it's raining outside.
I'll get you your copy of the poem.
Mrs. Stone, I wonder if I might ask Marianne a few questions.
She's asleep right now. Perhaps I can answer for her.
All right. Do you know if Marianne ever wears stockings?
Obviously, she has no reason to.
Does she own any?
I don't believe so.
Do you?
Oh, really, Mr. Zeno.
I'm back. Here it is.
Linda, do you wear stockings?
Are you suggesting that Linda might have killed Christine?
Somebody in this house did.
Why, that's preposterous.
Oh, that couldn't be, Mr. Zeno.
Well, I think it could.
As long as we're making accusations, sir, my guess is that my ex-son-in-law is the culprit. Or maybe you're the one. You're hiding him, aren't you?
Let me show you something, Mrs. Stone. This is Visions of Marianne number 4. Typed by your granddaughter on a machine I assume is in this house. Now, notice how the very top of the tall letters are chopped off. Now, take a look at this. See? It's from the same typewriter.
No, I don't think so.
Well, look at it.
Oh, Mr. Zeno, I should throw you out of my house for speaking in such a tone of voice. But the police are on their way, so I won't.
Grandma, you called the police. Why?
Because they're looking for your father, and Mr. Zeno knows where he is. He drove up in your father's car.
Were you really at the market this afternoon when I called?
I didn't know you called.
Linda, were you here all day today?
You don't have to answer him, dear.
Well, all day except for a few hours this morning. I went to the library.
You left your mother here alone?
No, Grandma was here with her. Weren't you, Grandma?
No.
Mother, you're standing up.
Help her, Linda.
No, leave me alone. I'm perfectly all right now. I heard everything. Zeno is right. Somebody here did kill Christine, and Fritz Emanuel, too.
I wrote those letters.
Oh, no, you didn't, Mother. I did. I waited 5 years to get even for what people did to me. Oh, they're coming for me. I'll put on some decent clothes.
Poor Marianne. You know, I don't know what else to say.
My theory is those electric shock treatments she was given 5 years ago had something to do with what happened. To her mind, things got blown out of proportion. She felt betrayed by Christine for replacing her and by Emmanuel for stealing your other love. Your work.
Well, I'm just terribly sorry it happened, for everyone's sake, especially Linda Zeno.
Well, you'll both be starting out again, together anyway. Right now seems like a good time.
Hey, Zeno, what crazy stunt do you have planned?
No stunt. It's work. I'm teaching a night course at City College in photo silk screening. Linda's already said she'll come. Come on, I came to your opening.
All right. Promise me one thing. Not a word about purple highlights.
Right.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Death on Canvas is an original radio drama written by Sue Donah. Peter Lupus was heard as Tom Crock. Featured in the cast were Charlie Dugdale, Peggy Walton, Jerry Hausner, Logan Ramsey, and Janet Waldo. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions, Incorporated. The music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.